गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, नाउ टुडे इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर लाइफ प्रोसेस विच इज एक्सक्रीशन। ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ डाइजेशन, रेस्पिरेशन, transportation and last one is excretion, which are necessary for the life. Mean these are the different process which are compulsory for the life, to exist life, to survive in environment. The last one is excretion. Excrete mean to remove. What substance have to remove which is not useful for body? It means the substance which is excreted out from body, that process is known as excretion. Means what are the waste material, what are the toxic substance which is not useful for our body, that should be removed out, that should be excreted out from our body. Which are, that will be excreted in form of what? In form of liquid, in form of solid, in form of gases. In form of gases, we already discuss in respiratory systems, the gas which is excreted out, removed out from our body, which is CO2 during the process of respiration, and that will be excreted out through the lungs. That will be gaseous state. And the solid states, that will be excreted out from our body through the process of digestion. That will be alimentary canal. And the liquid states, that will be urine formation or urea, that will be excreted out from our body, which is not useful for our organ, for our cell, for our body organs, which is liquid form. It is urea which contain nitrogenous waste. And now we are to, let's start excretion, the process to remove the harmful metabolic waste from our body. From the body, it means the waste which are harmful for our body, that has to be removed, and the by the process that has to be removed is known as excretion. In unicellular, unicellular means single cell organism. In unicellular, the organism, how the unicellular organism to remove their toxic substance from their body, they remove the waste product from their body by the simple method of diffusion. It means they excrete the waste material from their body, from the surface of the, or the from the outer membrane of the cell of the organism. Unicellular means single cell, like amoeba, means excrete out from any point on the surface of the organism. It means unicellular organisms remove these substances. These substances mean waste material. These waste material by the simple diffusion from the body surface into the surrounding. Means remove the waste product from its body to the surrounding by the from the surface of the body. If the multicellular means more than one cell, then the complexity of an organism will increase. It means more number of cells, more number of tissue will form. It required a specialized or specific cell, tissue or organ to remove the waste material from its body. Excretion in human being. Today we will discuss what is the, it include what are the different organs or the part which is used to in excretion of human being. First is pair of kidney. Kidney is the excretion unit organ. Excretory organs means kidney is the excretory organ which remove the waste material in liquid form, which dissolve in the blood. Blood with that oxygenated blood that flow out in our body, and which also contains some nitrogenous waste, that will filter in the kidney. It means kidney remove the nitrogenous waste from the blood and store, and that will be taken in the filter by the kidney. And kidney had the smallest unit, that is the nephron. It means the smallest unit of excretory system is nephron. and the second is pair of ureter, the which drain out urine from the kidney. It means this is the duct passage through which the kidney has to be, urine has to be passed, wet waste material has to be passed, urea has to be passed in liquid form. Ureter is the tube-like structures. This kidney has two, one right and another left, and also attached to the ureter is the tube-like structure which attached to the kidney and urinary bladder, and that is the tube-like structure which carry the urine or nitrogenous waste which was filtered from blood by the kidney. The pair of ureter which drain out urine from the kidney means take out urine substance, urine or waste substance from the kidney, and that pass to the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is a reservoir, is a vessels like a big vessels, but in which store something. Here is reservoir, big reservoir which store the urine, and this urinary bladder attached with the ureter to the kidney. Ureter is used to connector between the kidney and the urinary bladder. And last one is urethra, that is the passage which passes to remove the waste nitrogenous substance, waste toxic substance in liquid form, or the urine or the urea in liquid form from the body. Urethra is the channel to exterior, which has to remove from the body to the environment. And the pair, this the diagram you have to draw from the figure or from the book. Please draw diagram carefully. I request you. Human excretory system, why it is useful to us? First, human excretory system maintain water in our body and maintain pH, means salt solution. What is the nature of the pH solution, whether it is acid, base or neutral? pH, presence of hydrogen, which indicate the presence of hydrogen, which indicate the nature of salt which present inside our body is acidic, basic or neutral. It means it regulate the pH equilibrium in our body. And also ionic substance, that will be equilibrium or equalized by the excretory system. It helps to excrete out the waste product urea which dissolve in the blood. It means human excretory system is to remove the waste material from our body which is present in the blood, and to excrete the poisonous substance like drug and toxin and drug which is present in our blood, that has to be removed out from our body. And it regulates the blood pressure, means blood pressure is regulated. That will be, it means that will be waste material that will be excreted out from our body, and the more excretion will take place, it means removing the waste material inside the body which have to regulate the blood pressure in our body. How the urine is formed in our we know that kidney is the filtration organ. It means it filtered the waste substance from the blood, and which contain many smallest unit, filtration unit is called nephron. Nephron is the filtration unit of the excretory system which present in the kidney. With this, nephron is made up of a cluster of thin wall capillaries. It is made up of a cluster, means many more jhund group. Cluster of thin wall capillaries means it is the group of the thin wall capillaries, and these thin wall capillaries is called glomerulus. Glomerulus, which is a cluster of thin wall capillaries. It means nephron is made up of thin wall capillaries combination, and these thin wall capillaries combination called glomerulus, and associated with the cup like structure Bowman capsule. From the diagram if we will check, it contains the cup like structure. Here is the, this is the cup like structure, this is the Bowman capsule. And between the glomerulus is attached to the cup-like structure which is known as Bowman capsule. It means glomerulus is attached to the Bowman capsule, which is a cup-like structures, and long tube terminated through this capsule, and that will be ends with the tube-like structures tube-like structure, long tube terminated through this capsule. It means that this capsule is connected with the long tubes and the renal arteries. Renal arteries carry the oxygenated blood with the nitrogenous waste. The renal arteries bring oxygenated blood to the kidney along with the nitrogenous waste. Renal artery which carry the blood, and that blood is oxygenated but also contains some nitrogenous waste, and that will be bring that blood bring to the kidney to filter. And the blood, that blood which is contain also the nitrogenous substance, filter through the glomerulus. Through the glomerulus means that nitrogenous substance present in the oxygenated blood, that has to be filtered through the glomerulus. Glomerulus is the group of cluster of thin wall capillaries. Glomerulus and entered to the tubular of the nephron. The tubular is a tube-like structure. It means after glomerulus, it will enter to the tubular part of the nephron. The renal artery first. The renal and first one is the filtration organ is kidney, which contain the filtration unit is nephron. Filtration unit is nephrons, and the nephron is combination or the made up of the cluster of thin wall capillaries, which is known as glomerulus, and this will be associated with the attached with the cup-like structure which is known as Bowman capsule, and which is further terminated and with the tubes, long tubes to the capsule. And the renal artery which carry the blood with oxygenated blood with nitrogenous waste, mean we can say the impure blood, some impure blood, and that will be carried to the kidney by the renal artery. Renal artery carry the blood to the kidney, and that kidney will filter the deoxygenated blood with nitrogenous waste in the glomerulus and enter to the tubules of the nephrons, tubular part of the nephron. This filtered liquid part which was in the tubular part moved down from the tubular of the nephron is moved down and reabsorbed by the blood vessels. It means that filtered part from the tubular part of the nephron is again reabsorbed by the blood vessels. And surrounding these tubes, these reabsorbed are ammonia, amino acid, salt, glucose and water. Salt, glucose, water and amino acid that are reabsorbed by the blood vessels surrounding these tubes, means the tubules which contain the blood vessels, and that will be reabsorb the nitric waste, means the amino acid, water, salt. And then this fluid now, after reabsorbing, what is left now? The left fluid is now flowing into the tubular part, which is urine. And that will be the fluid which is flowing in the tubular part now. Now the fluid which is flowing in the tubular part is known as urine, and that will be collecting in the collecting duct, which is known as collecting duct together in the kidney. That will be collecting duct in the nephron, and which leave the kidney through the ureters and collected in the urinary bladders, ureter. And this ureter is raised the urine into the urinary bladders, where it is stored until expect the urine to pass out. It means function of neuron, excretion of the nitrogenous waste. It means removal of the nitrogenous waste from the body to maintain water and ionic substances and the pH equilibrium in our body. Simply, and there will be excretion in plant and also. What are the substances excreted out by the plant? These are as follow. And the waste material excretes by the plant, which is not useful for the
plant. First is excretion in plant, O2, oxygen and carbon dioxide, that will be excreted out through the stomata, exchange of gas, and CO2 is also released by carbon dioxide by the process of respiration. It means respiration is also take place in plant. And second is excess water which is not useful for the plant, and that water removed by the plant by the process of transpiration. Many plants lose some material other that which is not required by the plant, old plants, shedding of leaves, falling of leaves and falling of ripened fruits which is not required by the plant, they remove these substances. These are the waste material according to the plant. And this will be old part like old leaves and the bark of the tree which are excreted out from the plant, which they are not useful for the plant. Therefore, it remove from its some waste material like resin and gum. Some waste material like resin and gum excreted by the plant. The resin and gums, resin is the powder like structure, powders, and gums, which you know it very well, the gum is formed, we obtain from the plant. That is the waste material according to the plant, which is not required by the plant, that is excreted by the plant. And the plant excretes some waste material into the soil. It means it also lose waste material around the soil which is not visible. But these are the waste material which is not required by the plant, that excrete out from its part is the excretion, will take place in the excretion of plant. And this one was the last. And the last class we will discuss the question. If the question is related, repeated or the same, or which we already discussed, need not to be discussed. Otherwise, try to solve yourself. All question you can solve. And solve all the question first yourself, and then you can check in the next class. If you go through the videos, then all question will clear to you. In the next class, we will discuss the question from the textbook question or blue box. Be safe at home. Thanks. Be happy.